Hail Satguru Dev. All devotees are requested that the spiritual discourse is about to start. Please settle down peacefully at the discourse site and listen to the discourse with devotion. The loving souls of God are requested again that the spiritual discourse is about to start. Please settle down peacefully at the discourse site and listen to the discourse with devotion. Sat Sahib.
Viewers, the spectacular and supernatural spiritual discourses of the universe guru, Saint Rampalji Maharaji, have brought a revolution in the spiritual knowledge not only in India but also across the world. Millions of devotees have sent congratulatory letters for broadcasting our spiritual discourses. Along with this, a few devotees have sent in their doubts too. We met Sant Rampalji Maharaji for a solution to problems of devotees and answering their serious major problems. So let's listen to solution of all the queries of devotees offered by most revered Sant Rampalji Maharaji itself. So let's listen to solutions of all the queries of devotees offered by most revered Sant Rampalji Maharaji himself.
So pious souls, how will we find out unless we are told about it? God himself came, lived here for 120 years and went back. We didn't know how to recognize the ruby, due to which we kept failing. And it is one thing to make a statement, but I will prove with evidence that in this world, no one possesses spiritual knowledge or any solution, and that there is no God like Kabir, and there is no knowledge like the one given by God Kabir himself to this servant of God. To this servant. Supreme Father God, Purna Brahma, creator of the entire nature, God Kabir, has bestowed a special grace on all of us human beings. He has himself come and given us this knowledge that why we are taking birth and why are we dying. The property and the offspring whom we strive to protect day and night, all this gets destroyed in front of our eyes. What is the reason behind this? By souls, there was no one who could impart this knowledge to us, as a result of which we could not see an alternative to this. We considered it to be final that birth and death will continue. Today we realize this because no one could remove this question mark to date as to why we die and why we take birth. We form such a nice family and we have so much love in them, affection and attachment. And in a matter of a second, we lose everything. If sometime we get worried about this, then we conclude that this is happening with everyone. We have considered it to be a norm that this will definitely happen, but let us continue with our work. Which work shall we continue to do? Construct villas, bungalows, buy a luxurious car and then die. What kind of work was this? All the incidents that are happening with us, you see every day in any village or at anyone's home. Even we ourselves have faced many such incidents. So why is this all happening? So for that, God himself comes and enlightens us that we have come to this wrong world. God himself explains the true way of worship, the real process and procedure to get rid of this disease of birth and death. And for that, God himself comes along with his body from where he is residing. So God reminds us to peek a bit into the past and in the future, and not to limit ourselves to the present only. If we peek into our past, look into the past, then what does God state? God has himself come and imparted spiritual knowledge to his beloved soul Garib Dasji. What has he said? Bhai aage gaye na baavre. Aage means the ones who have already departed. Aage gaye na baavre, ye rehte bhi sab jahi. Bin sahib ki bandagi kahin thor thikana nahi. Our grandfather, great-grandfather went away, and there is not even a trace of them anywhere. No one knows in which creature's body they might be suffering, and they had wished for their clan to prosper. Even their clan propagated, but what did they achieve? And where is the clan before them who have all died? There is not even a trace of them. So here God states to explain to us, kya mangu kuch thir na rahai, ye dekhat nain chala jag jai, ek lakh poot sawa lakh naati, us ravan ke divana baati. On obtaining a child, even if you will share felicitations for 2 days, God says Ravan had 1 lakh. He had 1 lakh sons, and no one from his clan is alive today to light a lamp. There is no trace of him. His lineage got destroyed. He also died, and even his kingdom ended. So God wants to remind us. God has reminded us that this is the plight of whatever has happened in the past. You are currently witnessing that no living being is happy here, and everyone has a desire to become a millionaire, to become extremely wealthy, to build a magnificent bungalow, to buy a car, to be respected in the world. Because this is what we have learned so far. So God says that even if you acquire all this, like there are many who have big bungalows, and as a result of their past virtues, they have big cars and they also have excessive wealth. And you also see that in a moment, anybody can die. Wealthy businessmen are found dead inside their own helicopters after a crash. What will happen next? God cautions us for future.
Phir piche tu pashua kije gadha bail banai.
Aur ye chhappan bhog kahan man bore. Kahin kurdi charne jai. We cannot believe it at the moment because we have all the comforts.
And this Kal God has mechanized our mind in such a way that we are always thinking that work has to be done, that has to be done, that work is remaining, I will do that. So this is also inspiration of Kal, and he has constrained you. He has imposed so many responsibilities on you. And for what reason? For a stomach. For a subsistence. To keep this body safe, one has to build a house, wear clothes, and have food. All this is for the protection of the body so that it remains fine. And there is no guarantee when it might perish and for what reason.
So here God says, Kabir ye tan jayega, sake thutha harla. Ek seva kar satguru ki aur govind ke gun ga. One day this mortal body of yours will be destroyed, and as soon as the end of your human life will come, you will immediately perish, no matter how much work of yours is pending.
At that instance, it will not be seen that your boy is not married or the girl is yet to be married. Karl will not see this.
A devotee was telling that his maternal uncle had 5-6 girls, and due to the wrong tradition of dowry in our society, we have considered girls to be a curse on us. In their dowry, one has to make a lot of unnecessary expenditure. Because of which, he said that his maternal aunt had gone to invite people. The marriage of 3 girls had been kept at the same time. A person who has many daughters contemplates to bear all the expenses at once
and wishes everything to go well. Now, how much burden would there be on the mind of a parent whose 3 daughters are about to be married? That parent is continuously engrossed in thoughts while walking somewhere. In this way, she was standing at the bus stand, engrossed in her own thoughts. I will bring such things, I will do like this, money will be available from there. Meanwhile, a bus driver was reversing his bus, reversed it incorrectly, and she got squashed between a pillar of the bus stand and the bus. She was unaware as she was engrossed in her own thoughts. She died on the spot, hence God says, at the time of your death, not even a single breath will be granted to you. Further, God says, God has provided a solution to this. Kabir ye tan jayega sake tho thahar la. Ek seva kar satguru ki. And then do worship as guided by him or Govind ke gunga. The meaning of thahar is support. And so God says, this human life of yours will end when the time comes and all your work would be left pending. To avoid this, you will have to take the support of the true mantra of God via the true guru. After getting that support, your life will be extended. And that support too can only be obtained after taking refuge of Almighty God Kabir.
No one else, including Brahma, Vishnu, Shiv, Brahma and Parbrahma, is capable of extending your life. So here God says, Kabir ye tan jayega aur sake tho thahar la.
Then that thahar has been explained, which thahar? Ek seva kar satguru ki aur Govind ke gunga.
So God himself has come and given that knowledge, which is a special support, special way of worship by which God helps us.